We hope you will enjoy the following ranking. Please let us know your favorite in the comments, and make sure to subscribe to never miss a good movie again.
Number 5.
What do you say? I want you to be my VP. I want you. You're my vice.
Well, George, I'm the CEO of a large company. And I have been Secretary of Defense. And I have been White House Chief of Staff. The vice presidency is a mostly symbolic job.
Uh-huh.
However, if we came to a different understanding, I can handle the more mundane jobs, overseeing bureaucracy, military, energy, and foreign policy.
Yeah, right. I like that.
When you have power, people will always try to take it from you, always.
Are you even more ruthless than you used to be? Right at the guard, first in command, my testimony, when I take the stand.
So we gonna do this thing, or what? I mean, is this happening?
I believe we can make this work.
Hot damn!
Number 4.
We here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain. That this nation under God shall have a new birth of freedom. That government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
We can't tell our people they can vote yes on abolishing slavery unless at the same time we can tell them that you're seeking a negotiated peace.
It's either the amendment or this Confederate peace. You cannot have both.
How many hundreds of thousands have died during your administration?
Congress must never declare equal those whom God created unequal.
Read the Constitution alone.
We are stepped out upon the world stage now, with the fate of human dignity in our hands. Blood's been spilled to afford us this moment. Now, now, now!
Abraham Lincoln has asked us to work with him to accomplish the death of slavery.
No one's ever been loved so much by the people. Don't waste that power.
This fight is for the United States of America.
Think we choose to be born, or we fit it to the times we're born into?
Well, I don't know about myself. You may be.
This settles the fate for all coming time. Not only of the millions now in bondage, but of unborn millions to come. Shall we stop this bleeding?
Number 3.
Good evening. I shall resign the presidency at noon tomorrow.
This is an historic day, the only time a president has ever resigned from office.
Nixon knew about the Watergate cover-up.
The man who has committed the greatest felony in American history will never stand trial.
I've had an idea for an interview, Richard Nixon.
You're a talk show host.
I spent yesterday watching you interview the Bee Gees.
Weren't they terrific?
Why would I want to talk to David Frost?
I got $500,000.
Really?
Frost has hired 3 crack investigators.
Can I be crack one?
Can I be deep crack?
Can I shake his hand?
After everything he's done in this country, are you kidding me?
Oh, pleasure to meet you.
Mr. President.
That was devastating. I mean, I don't think he's ever going to get over that.
Frost is just not in your class, sir. You're going to be able to rebuild your reputation.
This entire project is a joke.
I do hope that isn't coming out of your own pocket.
I wish my pockets were that deep.
I'm in this for everything I've got.
There's a reason they call him Tricky Dick.
Stand by to roll tape.
You had a pleasant evening last night?
Yes.
4, 3, 2.
To do any fornicating?
And... Hugh David.
The American people need a conviction. I'd like to give Richard Nixon the trial he never had.
Democracy depends on it.
We're not gonna let that happen. We're gonna make them choke on power and glory.
Why didn't you burn the tapes?
I didn't want to take any questions on Watergate.
Shut it down.
I will ruin you if it takes the rest of my life.
What have I done?
If in this interview Nixon exonerates himself,
4,
that would be the worst crime of all. 3, 2, cue David.
Are you really saying the president can do something illegal?
I'm saying that when the president does it, that means it's not illegal.
I'm sorry.
Number 2.
Unit 1 to Unit 2.
What?
We're home. Base 1 to Unit 1. Base 1 to Unit 1.
Hold it, you mother! Hold it! Police!
There's been a break-in at Democratic headquarters, and they were bugging the place.
Woodward, Bernstein, you're both on the story now. Don't get up.
Redford.
I'm Bob Woodward of the Washington Post. Mr. Markham, are you here in connection with the Watergate burglary?
I'm not here.
Hoffman.
Hi, this is Carl Bernstein of the Washington Post, and I was just wondering if you can remember...
All the President's Men. The story of the two young reporters who cracked the Watergate conspiracy.
White House.
Howard Hunt, please.
He might be in Mr. Colson's office.
Who's Charles Colson? Did you know, Howard Hunt?
Well, the White House said he was doing some investigative work.
What do you say?
They stumbled into leads.
Certainly it comes as no surprise to you that Howard was with the CIA.
No surprise at all.
They tripped over clues.
We'd like to see all the material requested by the White House.
All White House transactions are confidential.
This whole thing is a cover-up. It's right on our nose.
And piece by piece, they solve the greatest detective story in American history.
There is no way the White House can control the investigation.
I don't want to say anymore, okay?
Have you been threatened if you tell the truth?
Is there a cover-up?
Don't you understand what you're on to?
Mitchell knew?
Of course Mitchell knew.
Woodward! Bernstein! Get in here!
At times, it looked as if it might cost them their jobs.
You guys are about to write a story that says the former attorney general, the highest-ranking law enforcement officer in this country, is a crook.
Their reputations.
Why is the Post trying to do it? I don't know.
Perhaps even their lives.
Number 1.
If I answer that question you keep asking, if I give you the name of the big enchilada, you know, then it's Bon Voyage Dino. I mean like permanent. I mean like a bullet in my head, you dig? Does that help you see my problem a little better?
Out of the corner of my eye, I saw a flash of light in the bushes, and then shots rang out.
No cloak and dagger stuff, you know. They call it Operation Mongoose.
It's gonna be okay, Dave. You just talk to us on the record and we'll protect you. And I guarantee it.
You are so naive.
You found us in your office. We think the conference room is also bugged, maybe the phones.
I'm not cooperating here. Listen, there's a death warrant for me.
Are the same people gonna kill us, Pop?
Nobody's gonna kill us.
Y'all gotta get into your minds how the hell the spooks think. Now, they're not ordinary crooks. Think the unthinkable. Question everything. Now, we're through the looking glass here, people.
White is black, and black is white. You don't believe me? All this time, you never believe me.
I just want to raise our children and live a normal life. I want my life back.
Jordan, hey, look, this thing's bigger than all of us.
Now, how many corpses is it going to take for you lawyers to figure out what you want?
People got to know. People got to know why he was killed.
Do you know what you've done to me? I'm a dead man!
Well, if they can kill the president, they can certainly get me.
You're a mouse fighting a gorilla.
You're close. You're closer than you think.
There's going to be an attempt to kill you somewhere between here and New Orleans.
I say let justice be done or the heavens fall.
Do you agree with our list? Please let us know in the comments. And for more top 5 movie videos, be sure to subscribe to communiTV.